Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is David, and today I'm going to be reviewing the Renogy 500 amp battery monitor. Before I get into it too much, I just wanted to mention that I actually have developed an easy solar system guide for any beginners or DIYers like myself. I'll link it in the description below. You can head over and check that out. I've been getting a lot of questions on some of my other videos about wire sizing, fuse sizing, location of components, and it's all in my guide, and it's only $14.99, so check that out if you have any hesitation or are worried about where to purchase any products or how much everything costs. It is all inside that guide. This is the battery monitor that we use to monitor our battery system. It is extremely accurate, really nice to have. I also use the BT2 Bluetooth monitor. That works well, but for accuracy and to really know how many amp hours I have left, this is what I use. It has been a while since I've done any reviews of the electrical components in our van, and I'm pretty excited to get back into it. If you've been following us, we just got back from Portugal a little while ago, and we are back in the van, which we missed dearly, and it has been a lot of fun back in Canada. But anyways, I wanted to go over all the features of this battery monitor. It's really handy to have, and it's like a necessity to have for your solar system to make sure you're monitoring your batteries correctly. You want to make sure that they're healthy and they're always being charged up as needed. The BT2 Bluetooth monitor that Renogy has made is really nice to have, just to pull out your phone, see how many amps are coming in from the solar, see how many amps are coming from the alternator while you're driving, basically. It's nice just to check. You can kind of see how much battery you've been using over the past few days, or so you can predict how much you need. It's really nice for that, but it's really not all that accurate. So having a battery monitor that has a shunt is ideal for monitoring your batteries. It's a lot more accurate. For those of you who don't know what a shunt is basically a component that is wired in to the negative battery cable right as it leaves the negative terminal on your battery, and it measures all the amps going in and out on that negative side. So it's very accurate. It's the most accurate way to monitor your batteries, how many amps are going in, how many amps are going out. You can see like how much each component uses. Like you can see how much your light uses. You can see how much your solar brings in. And it also gives you an accurate reading of how many amp hours you have left in your battery, which is ideally most important. Okay, so let's go over all the features and how to install it. This is my setup, guys. I know it looks a little messy, but I'll clear things up and I'll show you how I've wired my Renogy battery monitor. It is super simple. So basically all you have to do is connect this shunt right here. So I've connected it right to my bus bar, my negative bus bar, which made things really easy. Basically, it's just two bolts, one here, and then there's also this small power wire, which actually powers the backlight and the computer and everything for the monitor. Essentially, that's the power wire. So that's just a very small connection that's connected to my positive bus bar. And then right here is the other side of the data port, which you can see. It's really important to connect this in the right way, so that it senses properly, because if you connect it backwards, then it's not going to sense the amps properly. This wire is my main negative battery wire, which runs directly to my negative hookup right here. And then the data cable runs right to the battery monitor. There's plenty of cable there. I think there's 6 meters of cable, if I remember correctly. Anyways, there's plenty of cable, so you shouldn't have a problem finding a good place for it. This is basically where I have my battery monitor installed. You can see I just removed it. It is just underneath the seat here, which makes it tucked away. And I also have my Renogy inverter power switch right there, along with a switch for our signal booster right here, which I can turn on, which is also really nice. So what I've done is I've ran the data cable, basically bundled it up here because there's so much in it. And I'm just gonna go ahead and show you guys what it looks like there when I have it all. It's basically just press fit. There's no screws or anything on it, which is actually kind of nice. So this is what it looks like when it's all nice and installed. It has a nice finished look to it. I like the way it looks. It's really simple, easy to read. Okay, so this is the screen itself. We can go over all the features of the monitor and how to use it. On the left-hand side here, you have the battery symbol. It shows you how many amp hours is in your system, which you can customize based on how many amp hours your capacity is. I have 200 amp hours, so that's why it's showing 122 and 62%. Next to the amp hours is a set of arrows, you'll notice. And if these arrows are pointing down, there is a negative draw on your battery system. So even though my solar panels are bringing in a little bit of light right now, it's a really overcast day. They are not bringing in enough to compensate how much the light is using right now. And I think my fridge is also on, so that's why it is going down. And you can see below that it is negative 3.23 amps. So that is how much is being drawn out of my battery right now. The voltage is 13.1 volts. On the left there, and then 62% on the top right. That's how much capacity is remaining in your battery. And then right here is 42 watts. So right now I'm losing 42 watts, 3.21 amps. And this number right here actually tells me how long I can draw this amount of power until my batteries run out. So at the current state, I can use what I'm using for 38 hours, and that's when my batteries will be dead if I don't charge them again. So that's really nice to know, especially in the winter when you're using our diesel heater. I know how long I have until I can run out, so I know that diesel heater will never stop working, leave us freezing out in the cold. So I just went ahead and started the van, and I wanted to show you guys what it looks like when it's charging. So you'll notice that the two arrows right here are going up. The screen is actually like flashing as well, which signifies it's charging. And then you can see on the bottom that it has 20.5 amps coming in right now and 273 watts. So this number right here, again, instead of showing how many hours it'll take to drain, now it's showing how many hours it'll take to charge the battery actually. So that's really nice. If you wanna know how long you're gonna be driving for, you can calculate how many amps are gonna go into the battery, and that's how much you're gonna have or how long it'll take to charge it up. It's really basic, really easy to follow. Just like most Renogy products, it's really easy to use and install. And then on the back here, it says that I'm using the 500 amp hour model, and then there is just the cable outlet there, just the one. To customize the settings, we can hold the OK button right here. And then this is where you're gonna enter your capacity for your battery system. Mine's 200. You can also have alarms. So this is my high voltage alarm. This is my low voltage alarm. And then at the bottom here, I also have an alarm set for if my battery reaches 25 amp hours. And you can completely customize these by pressing the up and down arrow, hitting okay. So when you first install the battery monitor, you're going to want to make sure your battery is fully charged up to its max capacity. And then what you're gonna do, I'm not gonna do it because it's gonna reset mine. You're gonna hold the up arrow until this resets, and it doesn't take too long. It only takes a couple seconds. This will go to 100% capacity, and then you're basically good to go. Another nice feature with this is there's an internal battery. So if this ever gets unplugged, like I could unplug it right now, and then I can go ahead and plug it back in there, and it'll remember all of my settings. So that's really nice. If power is ever lost, there's an internal battery that keeps all your settings the same. So a couple small tips for you guys when you're installing that shunt. It's nice to bolt one side to either your battery terminal or a terminal on your bus bar. It just makes it quite a bit easier. That way you're not cutting wires and lining them up on both sides, since that gauge of wire is gonna be pretty thick. It's your main negative battery cable. So that's one tip there. And also make sure that shunt is orientated the right way, because if it's backwards, it's not gonna work properly. But other than that, it's really easy to connect. It's basically just that main negative battery cable, the small positive cable, and then your data cable, which goes to your screen. So that's pretty much it. If you have any questions regarding the installation, don't hesitate to comment below. That's how I installed mine. I like to keep my monitor kind of out of the way. It's also easy to access, but I didn't want anyone like bumping into it. If you want to check out this product, I will link it below. I also just want to say thank you to everyone who's been asking questions and engaging on the channel. It's really nice to go through and talk to you guys and answer your questions the best that I can. I've had a lot of fun doing that, and I really enjoy doing it. So if you have any questions regarding solar or the camper van build or anything else, feel free to comment below. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to check out my solar guide, I will link it below in the description. So feel free to check that out. It's an awesome guide, and I've had lots of positive feedback about it. Thank you guys so much for watching again. Be sure to subscribe to the channel, like this video, and I will see you in the next one.